City Cobra. There are so many other Cobras around. The Lone Star Cobra, Don Curry.
That's right.
Luigi Minchillo, who comes in with a record of 42-2. 28 years old. Began his pro career January 1977. Won his first 17 fights. And there you see the tail of the tape and the big edge. Look at the height and reach advantage.
That reach advantage is just tremendous. It's something that Luigi Minchillo really has to, he's got to cut it down.
Here are the introductions from Jimmy Ingram.
Ladies and gentlemen, Gold Circle Productions, in association with the Do It in Detroit campaign, presents the WBC Super Welterweight Championship of the World. All bouts on this card are under the supervision of the Michigan State Athletic Board of Control Chairperson Dr. Stuart Kirschenbaum. The officials appointed for this championship match are as follows. Our judges are Cesar Ramos of Puerto Rico, Abraham Severia of Mexico, and Guy Jutras of Canada. Our referee, the third man in the ring at this time, Waldemar Smith of Puerto Rico. Waldemar Smith. Introducing, in the blue corner, he's wearing green trunks with white trim. At 153 pounds, his professional record is 42 wins, 2 losses. Ladies and gentlemen, from Italy, the former European junior middleweight champion, Luigi Minchillo. Minchillo! In the red corner, wearing gold trunks with multicolored trim. His professional record, 37-1. At 153 and 3/4 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, from Detroit, Michigan, here's the WBC Super Welterweight Champion of the World, the Motor City Cobra, Thomas Hearns!
Sam Rosen and Randy Gordon, happy to be bringing you this championship bout. Scheduled for 12. And Randy, why don't you go over the WBC rules?
Well, for this title fight, there is a 10-point must scoring system. There is a 3-knockdown rule in effect. In the case of a fighter getting down, there is a mandatory 8-count. A fighter can be saved by the bell only in the last round. And in the case of a butt, well, then we'll go to the scorecards after the third round. Before the third round, it's a technical draw.
Scheduled for 12. And we are set to go. Thomas Hearns and Luigi Minchillo. Minchillo, two losses in his career, was knocked out in 1978 by Alvaro Scarpelli. Lost a 10-round decision to Roberto Duran in September of 1981. Minchillo, pretty good defensive fighter. Look for him to go to the inside. Minchillo. 6'1", and maybe even taller.
Minchillo has a lot to make up for. Something like 4.5 inches shorter than Hearns and about a mile deficiency in reach. He's got to get close to Hearns from the start.
Emmanuel Stewart told Randy and I that he feels that jab of Tommy Hearns is very, very important in this fight to open up that right hand. Picking off the jab thus far. That jab got through nicely.
In the first round, Tommy Hearns has stopped 5 opponents. Minchillo has stopped 4.
Good right hand. That was a good one by Luigi Minchillo.
It certainly was. It hit Hearns flush on the jaw.
Quick snapping jab by Tommy Hearns.
remember, this is no stiff as Minchillo. He's a former Italian champion, a former European champion. He's never been off his feet. He went the distance with Roberto Duran, and the only time he was stopped was on a cut.
There you're going to see one of the difficulties Minchillo faces, that right hand coming up short.
Now we saw Wilfred Benitez's left hand, which is one of the best in the business. Watch the Cobra's left hand. It's amazing.
Look at that jab. Good luck to the body. This is to remind our cable system down the line at the end of this round. We'll have a local break. Hearns coming on strong. Good right hand. Minchillo is hurt. Hearns with the left hand tries to follow up. Minchillo smiling at Hearns and covering up. Hearns with tremendous confidence right now. Right, taken on the gloves by Minchillo. We are late in round one. And Hearns comes out looking sharp. First fight since July 10th. Final seconds of the opening round. And we'll be right back after this break from your local cable system. The end of round two. this one. If you tune in late, Willie Edwards stopped Matthew Saad Muhammad in the 11th round of TKO to retain the North American Boxing Federation Championship, light heavyweight championship. And then Wilfred Benitez won a unanimous decision over Stacy McSwain. Watch Benitez rush Tommy Hearns here. Go after Luigi Minchillo.
The left hand, the right hand, it's all coming because Tommy Hearns' jab tonight is so sharp that he's setting everything else up. And Luigi Minchillo is just awed by that right hand, awed and afraid. He doesn't want to get close to it. What he should do is get very close. He cannot hope to fight Hearns from the outside. There you see Tommy Hearns' cut man, Ralph Citro out of Blackwood, New Jersey. And could it be that Hearns already has a scratch on the side of his right eye?
Working on it. It doesn't look like it's anything that will bother him. It doesn't seem to be bothering him right now. This is round three, scheduled for 12. Tommy Hearns, the super welterweight champion of the world. Kilo with a right hand got in there. Jab is a good one by Hearns, but Minchillo is ready to mix it up. Hearns wants to back up Minchillo, and he's doing just that.
Number three has been the biggest round of Tommy Hearns' career. He has 10 third-round knockouts, and right now it looks like he's going to get number 11.
He got a good right hand in there, but Minchillo laughed at him. Minchillo covering up as Hearns varies the attack. Upstairs, then downstairs.
Sam, many times, I'd say 99% of the time, when a fighter laughs after getting hit, he's hurt.
In the battle of the jabs, Hearns must win. He's got a decisive reach advantage. Third round.
Well, so far he looks like the Motor City Cobra and the Hitman combined. Look at that left hook to the body and the right uppercut. I don't know what's keeping Minchillo on his feet.
Oh, no, it's okay. Come on.
Minchillo. Tough guy. Takes a left hook from Hearns and got in there.
Quite frankly, I don't know any welterweight or junior middleweight that can stand up to this kind of punishment. Remember, Minchillo has never been off his feet.
One of those closest punches, very close to being low by Hearns. Referee did not caution Hearns, though. Hearns has got it all his way. Minchillo is not doing anything to take Hearns out of his fight.
That footwork on the part of Tommy Hearns.
Oh, that's a beautiful combination.
And Sam, it wasn't just the combinations, it was a footwork. Tommy Hearns is not standing in front of Minchillo. He's moving left and right.
Minchillo trying to fight back into the left hook. Hearns smiling at Minchillo this time.
Which means he got hurt.
It stung a little bit. Minchillo's right hand scores as he tries to pull Hearns and lands with a right hand. Less than half a minute to go in the third round.
Minchillo's corner is imploring him. He's in his own corner. Stay there. Stay there.
That's what he's doing. And he's doing a good job. Hearns is smiling and laughing.
Well, he's trying to put on a show, but he's taking a few good shots, and he feels them.
A right hand by Minchillo as he has come back strong at the end of round three. In Detroit, the Super Welterweight Championship. Tommy Hearns, the champion. Luigi Minchillo, the challenger. Hearns in the gold. Minchillo in the green. This is round four. No knockdowns. We've seen Hearns throw everything in the arsenal. Minchillo still stands.
I'm sure the WBA welterweight champion Donald Cobra Curry is watching this closely from his ringside seat, as is Sugar Ray Leonard back in Palmer Park, Maryland.
How about Marvin Hagler?
Oh, the marvelous one, I'm sure. He always tells me, no, I wasn't watching it. I don't even care about Hearns.
Minchillo got in that counter right hand. And that right hand came up short.
And, of course, the other champion is not too concerned about fighting Thomas Hearns, the WBC champion, because he's Tommy Hearns' stablemate, Milton the Iceman McCrory. Oh, yeah, he got hurt again. Tommy Hearns moved out of there, gave him a big rim, but that was a solid punch by Minchillo.
Glancing right hand to the side of the head by Minchillo. Tommy Hearns not fought since July 10th, when he defeated Murray Sutherland. Sutherland, the late replacement for James Hard Rock Green in a non-title bout. And I would say about the fifth round, Tommy Hearns hurt his right hand and fought the rest of that fight exclusively with a left. Or just about the rest of the left. Nice spin out by Tommy Hearns.
And in that fight last July 10th, he got up to this kind of start against Murray Sutherland, who also has a real solid chin. And then Tommy tired badly in the fight, got cut around both eyes. Murray came on very strong. He got a question with Minchillo. We can tell he's never been down before. Is he going to come on strong?
Unfortunately for Minchillo, that reach is just too short. He's missing with those hooks. The quickness of Hearns is shown as he backs away. Minchillo's got a charge in there, try to mix it up on the inside. A little swelling under the left eye of Luigi Minchillo. Under half a minute to go in the fourth round, scheduled for 12.
Some nice defense on the part of Thomas Hearns. He's just moving his head to the right and to the left. And Minchillo cannot land a punch. Just missed
it. Hearns starting to pick it up with the jab and follows with a chopping right.
That's a red crash from that. He's pressing it.
End of round four. Into the corner of Tommy Hearns, Emmanuel Stewart, his trainer and manager.
I'm looking at the right hand. You haven't taken the right hand.
You see what Tommy Hearns says. He needs to win impressively. Thus far, he looks good. We haven't seen that hitman power.
As an amateur, Tommy Hearns won 155 fights and lost only 8. And Sam, this is going to come as a shock to a lot of people. Out of those 155 victories, he knocked out only 12 opponents.
Right.
It wasn't until he became a pro that he started learning leverage. But I think now, as he's up in weight, he's lost a little bit of power. He's really not the hitman that he was early in his career when he was knocking everybody out with one punch. Look at that. That's a nice crowd.
And the people of Detroit have reason to be proud. Certainly the mayor has been smiling all night across the way. He got involved totally in this promotion. They feel it will help the image of Detroit. They want people to feel and know that Detroit is alive. Certainly there's a lot of life in this arena tonight. Minchillo. Let Hearns come out of the corner. Looked like he wanted the knockout early in the first couple of rounds, didn't get it. Now is settled down to box. Left hook, and that hurt Minchillo. The body, Hearns follows nicely. Oh, Hearns is loading up for a one-punch knockout. It seems like that's what he's doing. He had Minchillo hurt.
You're absolutely right. Hearns is looking for that one shot with either hand that can end his fight. And I don't think he can stop Minchillo with just one shot.
Good jab now by Hearns.
Oh, he's hitting Minchillo to the body with a jab the way he hit a heavy back. Plus a guard.
Minchillo keeps coming, and the jab keeps stinging him. Hearns ties him up. Midway through the fifth round. No knockdowns in this fight. Luigi Minchillo. Policeman from Italy. Goes after Hearns and scores.
Well, that has never been Tommy's fight on the inside. Why he's doing that is beyond me.
Why he's standing up against the ropes is a surprise. Where Minchillo is at his best.
Tommy can't do himself anything but no good on the rope. He can get butted on the ropes, caught on the ropes. He's got 4.5 inches in height.
About left hand.
And about 5 inches in reach. He should be doing just what he's doing outside. Now, that's wrong.
This is to remind our cable systems down the line. At the end of this round, we'll have a local break. Kilo crowding Hearns.
Tommy was about to start talking to Minchillo. He starts saying something, then he realized, hey, this guy doesn't speak English.
This jab by Hearns. Final seconds, round 5. We'll be right back after this break from your local cable system.
Tieni sulle mani, non te ne devi approfittare, però è qui che voglio che mi stai a sentire in questo momento. Qualche volta se vai fuori non è male, capito? Girandoli fuori, eh? Hai capito? Mi raccomando, la vista e le mani
sempre. Sam Rosen and Randy Gordon ringside at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. This is round 6, scheduled for 12, the WBC Super Welterweight Championship on the line. With the champion Tommy Hearns going against Luigi Minchillo of Italy. And Minchillo has been tough.
Oh, has he been tough? In the first round, he was nearly out of there and it really looked like he was going to go. In the second round, he got wobbled, and in the third round, but then he started turning it on, and Tommy Hearns hasn't been doing as much work with the right hand.
This jab, and you have to wonder, is the right hand giving him trouble? Is it hurting again?
Let's watch it from here on in. See, I think he's trying to just set up that one big right hand with the jab. Look at the jab he's throwing. Hearns is throwing a very quick, cobra-like left jab.
But if he's saving that right hand, it could be that he doesn't want to throw it because it does pain him. We'll see. There's the right. Good one. Straight right hand by Hearns.
When a guy throws it to the body, if it's hurting, I doubt it's hurting now. What I think he's just trying to do is save it. He's doing okay with his left jab, just painting him up and down.
Nice combination of glancing right hand, though, by Hearns to the side of the head of Minchillo.
Look what he's doing with that jab. He's converting it into a hook. Combination by Thomas Hearns. He's got some of the fastest hands in the welterweight, junior middleweight, or middleweight division. A very picturesque, pretty combination. He just lets him go, and he rocked Minchillo with it.
Started with the right,
regained himself, and then lets both hands go.
And again.
And look at Tommy drive that right hand to the body.
Bell for round seven. Neither fighter has been down. Certainly, the detractors of Tommy Hearns have to be saying, well, look, he can't take out Luigi Minchillo. Who's Luigi Minchillo? Minchillo's been tough. Give him that much. He's a game fighter. Not too much known about him. He did go 10 with Roberto Duran a couple of years ago.
Well, those people who say he can't take out Luigi Minchillo, I say, who has taken out Luigi Minchillo?
But Hearns has fought a good fight. He has looked good. Minchillo putting on some pressure. And Hearns able to withstand.
Tommy left himself wide open that time. His chin was way up in the air when he threw the right hand to the body. A man with faster hands might have countered him with a hook. Like Sugar Ray Leonard.
I agree. Minchillo scored earlier with that looping right hand, but didn't have much on it.
At this point, I think Minchillo has to do, if you remember, former middleweight champion Vito Anafirmo. He's just got to get in close. He's got a street fight coming.
Hearns with picture shots with that jab in the right hand behind it. Minchillo keeps coming. Oh, that jab. That is some kind of punch. We're midway through the seventh round.
Well, those young fighters out there, that is a jab. Those hours on the heavy bag, on the mitts.
Skin. He's taking a lot of punches. The chant is Tommy, from the crowd of 18,453 in Joe Louis Arena.
It's got to be just depressing to Luigi Minchillo because he knows the only people really rooting for him are the two guys in his corner.
Far. Intent to use the jab mostly. Now going for the body with uppercuts. Half a minute to go. Round seven.
Well, the left eye of Minchillo is swelling, starting to close. And I can't believe it's taken this long with the amount of shots he has taken.
Jab has been in his face throughout the fight. Hearns slowing down just a little bit. Just a little bit. End of the seventh. Scheduled for 12. This is the Super Welterweight Championship of the WBC. The champion, Tommy Hearns, defending against Luigi Minchillo. Down in the fight. Minchillo's left eye is closing rapidly.
I'd say he's got maybe this round and the next round. By the end of the ninth round, if there is a ninth round, that eye will be closed. Because Tommy's zeroing in on the eye now. He sees it, and I think every shot is going to the left eye.
Hearns has had a sharp jab, which is one thing they were hoping for tonight, and he's done well with it. Experiencing any pain with that right hand. Right hand which has caused him problems in the past year. Minchillo! He landed to the head and to the body before Hearns tied him up. Slapping right hand to the side of the head of Tommy Hearns.
Just a bad place for Thomas Hearns to be on the inside.
Minchillo still strong, and Hearns, I get the feeling, is starting to tire a little bit. Don't forget, this is his first fight since July 10th.
Well, remember, when he won the title from Wilford Benitez in December 82. He took 7 months off and then fought Murray Sutherland. And it was just like this, about this round, he started to tire. Now, after another 7 month layoff, he's looked great for seven rounds. And once again, he's starting to run down just a little bit.
Right hand is landing. Body shots that time. That's a nice combination. Hilo keeps coming. Hearns ripping it right to the body. And again, great body shots. He's landing from all angles now. And Minchillo backs up. And we haven't seen that too much. Minchillo grimacing from what appeared to be a kidney punch.
The shot, as he was moving back, the shot hit him, I believe, in an illegal area, like back towards the kidneys. And that's a debilitating blow.
Big right hand by Hearns as he has opened up.
Referee Waldemar Schmidt of Puerto Rico has got his work cut out for him now, because this is turning into a very rough fight.
Hearns has ripped body shots in this round. He ties up Minchillo on the inside. As we come to the bell, ending round eight.
No, that's up there. Come on.
Crowd loves it. Tommy Hearns performing well. Minchillo was hurt in that round. You see them use the end swell. Try and control that swelling, or at least slow it down a little bit. That left eye is closing up rapidly on Luigi Minchillo.
And he's got a problem with the eye, and I think he's going to slow down a little. Look at these body shots. That one was a little bit low, the left hook. Another one to the side by Tommy Hearns. He concentrated his strong attack that round on the body.
And a right hand to the side of Minchillo, which may have been a little to the back. You felt it was a legal punch. Really hurt Minchillo. They continue to work on that little nick. It has not opened up. We haven't seen blood. Seems to be a little bit of an abrasion over the right eye of Tommy Hearns. Set for round nine, and Hearns is starting to open up a lead in this fight. It's scheduled for 12.
Well, Minchillo has to come in moving that head, moving the shoulders, bending at the knees. Because if he comes straight in, Tommy's just going to pick him apart like that with the jab all night long.
28-year-old Luigi Minchillo from Italy, the former European junior middleweight champion and now the number one contender in Europe, continues to get his head snapped back by that sharp jab of Tommy Hearns. Hearns moving well again. Hearns in great shape. Moving well again. This one, it looked like he was slowing down. He erupted in that eighth round.
Well, this could also be a psych maneuver. Tommy could be reaching down inside of himself and saying, if I get up on my toes and start dancing, even if it hurts me, it'll take some of that heart, tremendous heart, away from Minchillo. I assure you, Tommy's feeling it right now as he's trying to move.
Minchillo has just not been able to get inside enough to hurt Tommy Hearns, to slow him down, to take some of the fight out of him. He goes after him. It's been an occasional flurry like that. I've given Minchillo two rounds in this fight. And we are in round nine. Wraps him up.
Well, at the end of 1982, Luigi Minchillo thought about retirement, took a little time off. He owns a sport shop in Italy. It's a good thing he came back. Look at the fight he's given Tommy Hearns. Still stays on his feet.
Minchillo got in the right. Hearns scored with the left. This is to remind our cable systems down the line at the end of this round, we'll have a local break.
Well, through an interpreter yesterday in the hotel, a beautiful hotel we're staying in, Luigi Minchillo told me, I said, what's your style? How would you describe it? And through the interpreter, he said, I have no style. I'm a box, I can slug, I'm rough. You'll see tomorrow. And he's right, he has no style.
just got too much reach for him, too much jab for Minchillo. Minchillo keeps coming. Certainly made a fight out of it, that's for sure. Takes the left hand in there. Final seconds, round nine. We'll be right back after this break from your local cable system.
Respira profondo, eh? Respira profondo. Luigi, la senti per una battaglia? Eh? Accostati che puoi, eh? Via!
Randy Gordon, ringside at the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. You're watching the WBC Super Welterweight Championship. The champion Tommy Hearns, the challenger Luigi Minchillo. This is round 10, scheduled for 12. Neither fighter has been down, so it's turned into a one-sided fight for Tommy Hearns. Still up on his toes and still moving well.
Tommy cannot afford to get careless. On my unofficial scorecard, he's way out in front. Yet Luigi Minchillo just keeps coming and coming.
Left hook got in by Minchillo, but Hearns countered nicely with a hook of his own.
Because Minchillo has no real style, as we talked about. You just never know what he's going to do next. That overhand left, that overhand right, he comes from underneath, he mauls him.
Now there, he tried to get inside, but the fast hands of Hearns stopped him. And that's been the difference again. The reach, the good jab, the quick hands of Tommy Hearns.
There wasn't even a smile that time by Tommy Hearns. He felt it.
Late in a fight like this, you don't want to go down. You might be too tired to get up. As you said, you can't get careless. Gillo opening his arms saying, come on, what's this pushing business?
Right, he said, I want to fight on the inside. Come on, let's rumble here.
Critics of Tommy Hearns will say, why hasn't he been able to put down Luigi Minchillo? Where is the Tommy Hearns power?
Oh, you're looking at it. You're just looking at one of the toughest humans I've ever seen.
Less than a minute to go. Round 10. Hearns ripping shots. Minchillo taking. Keeps coming.
Sam, some of those other welterweights and junior middleweights out there have got to be saying, wow, I'm glad it's not me taking those shots. Look at them trying to muscle each other. As Hearns tried to shove Minchillo back, you saw the strength of Luigi. Tommy couldn't budge him.
Straight left by Minchillo, and again the hook by Minchillo.
The right hand by Hearns was very low, again below the belt. No bell. Both guys thought they heard the bell, and Waldemar Schmidt thought he heard the bell. According to
Milo, is running around the ring. He thought that Hearns had quit. He thought he had won the fight. Hearns had gone back into the corner thinking the round was over.
No, according to my stopwatch, it was the timekeeper was correct. I don't know what was on Luigi's mind. Maybe those left hooks he took shook him up more than we thought.
The manager of Luigi Minchillo complaining to the said that Hearns stopped fighting. He felt Hearns quit. Right there, he felt that Hearns had quit the fight. But Hearns, I believe, felt the round was over.
He thought the round was over. Emmanuel Stewart was starting to bring the stool in. There was some confusion there, and as a matter of fact, Waldemar Schmidt wasn't even sure. He didn't hear the bell, but he looked down towards the timekeeper, and there was still about 3 seconds to go in the round.
Hearns set to come out for round 11. There's the bell. They were ready to start before the bell rang.
I think think Waldemar Schmidt is mad at the timekeeper. He just waved his arms like, go. He didn't even wait for the bell. It's a new rule on Waldemar Schmidt's part. It's fight when I drop my hands.
Certainly a one-sided fight at this point, with Hearns way ahead.
But not easily. This is it might be a mismatch on the scorecard, but it's what I call a competitive mismatch.
Oh, there's no question that Minchillo has been tough. He has made Hearns work.
And for all those people who before the fight said, Luigi, who?
Benitez. Benitez winning a 10-round unanimous decision over Stacy McSwain. They saw the former light heavyweight champion of the world, Matthew Saad Mohammed, stopped in the 11th round by Willie Edwards. As Edwards retained his North American Boxing Federation light heavyweight title. Past the midway point of the 11th round. Scheduled for 12 is the WBC Super Welterweight Championship.
I gotta believe that after this fight, Luigi Minchillo, his body is gonna feel like he ran into a locomotive.
Oh, I think you have to call Minchillo a warrior. That's about all I can say for him. He takes some shots. He has taken some body shots. I wonder what his ribs are made of. Both eyes are now closing up on Luigi Minchillo.
I believe there was a shoulder butt inside. Minchillo took it and he looked at the ref. Schmidt didn't do anything. Oh, a double left hand. An uppercut with the left hand and then a hook by Hearns.
Half a minute to go in the 11th round. Minchillo's jabs, just the end of them, landing on the nose of Tommy Hearns.
To me. Smiling
at Minchillo, bouncing on the canvas. With a minute to go in the fight.
shape, because if he wasn't, he'd be all over Tommy at this point.
Half a minute to go in the fight. The crowd wants the knockout from Tommy Hearns. Right hand scores. Minchillo looking to survive. That's all. Minchillo backing off. He's satisfied to go the distance with Hearns. There will be no knockout. As we have come to the end of the Super Welterweight Championship bout. Sportsmanship, not quite like what we saw earlier when Matthew Saad Mohammed went absolutely wild when the fight was stopped against Willie Edwards. There is Tommy Hearns, goes 12 rounds and tough rounds against Luigi Minchillo of Italy. I don't think there's any question that Tommy Hearns has won this fight. I gave Minchillo 2 rounds in this fight. We will see what the official scoring is on the 10-point must system. Give Tommy Hearns 118 points and 110 for Luigi Minchillo. There is the former junior middleweight champion of Europe, Luigi Minchillo, currently ranked number one European contender. And you can see the swelling over both eyes as he was pounded by the jab of Tommy Hearns. Hearns threw great combinations in the fight. And a very happy Tommy Hearns. Randy Gordon is set to talk with the champion. As the cards still being tallied. And waiting for the scorecards to be handed up to Jimmy Ingram in the ring. Again, Tommy Hearns with his admirers. Now he will talk to the crowd.
Judge Dukas of Canada scored 118 Hearns.
question about that. And you saw the scoring one-sided by the judges. Luigi Minchillo getting two even rounds on the scorecard of one judge, winning one round on the scorecard of a judge, and then getting one even round on the third judge's scorecard. A fight dominated by Tommy Hearns, the Motor City Cobra, as he used the jab well, great combinations, had Minchillo hurt a couple of times in the fight, went for the knockout a couple of times, could not get it, did not put Minchillo down once in the fight, and certainly, as I mentioned during the course of the evening, critics of Tommy Hearns will question why he was unable to put down Luigi Minchillo, but certainly it was a fight he dominated. He's with Randy Gordon right now. Let's go into the ring to Randy
the face
and Tommy
of
Hearns.
A smiling Thomas, the hitman, Motor City Cobra Hearns.
Yes, I'm very happy with my performance and also with my turnout here. My fans supported me very well, and I'm very happy. And I have to say that it wasn't an easy job for me.
Thomas, before the fight, a lot of people were saying, Luigi, who? Have you ever hit a man so hard not to have him go down?
Well, I hit Minchillo with a lot of great shots, and he seems to stand in there. And I say to myself, ain't no use me wearing myself down, going in there, just going out, trying to take this man out, and he isn't going. I hit him with some terrible body shots, and I know I hurt him, but he stayed in there. That's a sign of a champion soon.
Emmanuel, assess his performance. Were you happy with it?
We felt that a lot of work has been made. He made his adjustment and got his job done tonight. And it's good that he has a lot of different styles that he can use, but he got hit more than he should have. And that's based on inactivity, so he's got to be a little more active now.
But what is the future for Tommy Hearns going to be? The rest of 1984, what's it going to be like?
We are looking at future-wise, a possible fight with Marvin Hagler and maybe even a fight with Roberto Duran, but he should have at least two big fights before the year's up.
How about, Thomas, I was with Sugar Ray Leonard a couple weeks ago, and he's made it public. He said, I'll fight everybody out there. Tommy Hearns can wait in line. What do you say about that?
I knew I was going to be in the wait. That's why I'm not waiting on a Ray Leonard. I'm going with my program. This don't make sense to me to sit back and try to wait on Leonard to make up his mind whether he want to fight me again or not.
Now, one big question that everybody had about you coming into the fight, your right hand, which you hurt against Benitez, you hurt against Murray Sullivan. Obviously, nothing's wrong with it now.
No, it's no problem with my right hand now. I'm able to get out there and put it out there, shoot it hard as I want, and not have any problem.
Okay, talk a little bit.